fast. The layman. So I'm going to break down this in the most obvious language, in the most understandable language. You're not going to hear of the codes of... So for the beginners, this one is special for you. Well, I don't think for some people like old Stephen Knappel. Says, in 20 years, it takes 20 years to build a reputation and a few minutes for a cyber incident to ruin it. You're going to take slips to get this knowledge. We put it out there, but it just takes one person and about an hour, if not less, and it is all down. In 2015, the President of the United States think a summit on cybersecurity said the cyber threat is one of the most serious economic and national security challenges we face as a nation. The United States is a first world country. This is where almost all these things begin from. So, and security. But if they find this a threat, then we also need to take it seriously. These are the statistics of the United States, specifically in this case. Data breaches and exposed records of the United States from 2005 up to 2017. But you see, the trend is going high. So which means there's some bit of laxity or some bit of unseriousness. The bad guys are really upping their game. 30%, more than 30%. Actually, 32%. To be more specific, of the website, but it has the highest, I think, this is my source, anyone can look for it, the Sukuri Hack Report 2017, in terms of being infected. This is worrying, this is not good, and each of us here should be thinking twice on how much our security is at threat. David Kennedy said, by some estimates, cybercrime is expected to globally cost up to about $6 trillion, put the incentives for the innovation and investment at risk, and will be more profitable than the global trade of all major drugs combined. So you hear people trading cocaine, you hear, they tell me, you have a kilogram of cocaine and you fly to the US, next time you're coming here, Corolla will be yours all. But these guys in cybercrime have the ability to make 6 trillion shilling in a year, which means we really need to wake up. We really need to take things seriously. So, what are things? Allow for users to create weak password. Just because you have some ex of yours, by the time you're joining Facebook, you love this girl so much. This one, this was around 2009, yeah. So my password was Patricia 2009. Uh-oh. Can you imagine? No. She left in 2012. I tried. So, giving administrative access to users who don't require it. You are in an IT firm or you built a project. You quite very many developers on it. These developers have different rules. Some of them don't need access to some of the files, to some of the content. So, but in this case, everyone has equal access everywhere. You know, if you're 10 people, my father always tells me a secret is supposed to be to you and maybe some other person. If it crosses to the third, then it ceases to become a secret. It's actually a public secret. Public secret is everyone knows about it, but they cannot talk about it. You get it? So anyone has potential to do anything, but they won't tell the other, which is risky. Not enabling HTTPS on your site and allowing users. There's a gentleman, the host, who was talking about secure and cyber content. Oh, I step up. Allowing file uploads from unauthenticated users or with no type checking. This one, people on if one person is the one charged with approving what content goes into our database, it will help. Because if all of us can upload to the database, then there's a problem. I will upload something I have no idea about, yet it is creating harm to our project. I think we are together, right? So, how do we stay safe? Staying safe is summarized right there. There are three words, and all of them mean the same thing. It is update, update, and update. What are we doing? Updating WordPress. There are very many versions. You find someone is running a big project, but they are still using a very obsolete version. It means there's something they've added. There's some content that is helpful. It might not be in the security field, in all the interface, quite very many things, but us keeping up on the latest versions is very paramount. Same applies to the plugins, same applies to the themes. This is self-explanatory. Why would you use a plugin that was developed 2 years ago, and yet there is one that was developed last month? So it would actually mean you do not find what the subsequent version is important. So, what do we do if we are hacked at run size? This is where we need to pay attention. You can no longer trust whatever you have because some other person out there has it. So what do? We destroy the site. Because you can't claim to have ownership over something, yet some other person out there who you actually don't know has the same rights like you have. So, in tech language, we call it nuke. Nuke is, it's used in the military, fighting with nuclear weapons. And you know how dangerous they are. So, you strike your nuclear weapon to this site that has been hacked. And then, what we do? Actually, before, you need to save, I don't know, those people that, I think all of us would be well versed with these two terms. I didn't want to involve any sort of these, but I had no option. Yeah, this is where we save all, I want to use the most language, where we save our login details, yeah, the database credentials, the passwords, okay, those that allow access to the site, you get?
And this
is where we save the content, this is the actual content, the pictures, the text, the data, everything. So these two, before you nuke your site, you save them somewhere because they're important. The whole site, these two are the foundations of the entire project. You get it? So you reinstall after you nuke the site. So we're going to start afresh. You reinstall data from the backups. These are the backups we've been doing. You see here, I ask you, you have the backups, right? Because you need to have the backups all the time. Like I've explained, what we back up, these are what we back up all the time. You can generate a consistent frequency, you don't know when the threat is coming. Now these are, I call them the help paranoia, but these are now the daily thing. But like I told you, don't use your ex's name password like me, but thank God I haven't hacked.
Two-factor
authentication. Do we all have an idea about what two-factor authentication means? We've all logged in
to our emails, Jim.
Enable this feature on your site, and actually, not limited to WordPress. Every other transaction, all your accounts online, you can enable this so that if someone is attempting to get in there, you're notified. This guy should call you or they should send you a text message or send you a code or send you an email so that you're fully aware when someone wants to have business with your site. Use separate WordPress logins
for publishing
day-to-day content and for site administration. This goes back to when the people have multiple access to this account. You need to restrict them by maybe you can upload. We'll take the questions later. Limit who can log into your site and what permissions they have. This is also, we've talked about it. Use secure protocols. Back to this gentleman's presentation. I'm sorry, I have to rush because I'm told I don't have to. Where only you. I want to give you a very quick example. I don't know. Those of you with your laptops or phones or anything with a login. To access this on that server. So if you go not, if you've not given attention to this, anyone out there, they'll give him the login page. So now that is where you hear about the brute force attack. Someone is going to think about your password. Like I told you, someone knows your ex and maybe or might be guessing your password. They're gonna try to hit it in there. And maybe luck gets them, then they actually have to, so I have to rush. That same goes for any other than this. Is, I think, the rest of my 2 minutes. Previous speakers have talked about free things. But I really want to disagree. And this disagreement is not in opinion. That your content has value. You love what you're doing. This is literally your life. To some developers, they have dedicated all their time, all their life to doing what they do. So if you don't secure what you have with value that is equivalent to the actual value of what you have, then there's a problem, because you keep subscribing to these free security, these SSL, all the other things, and you keep using these trial versions. Like, you see, if this happens to the big companies, Yahoo was hacked, and it just got to know recently. Facebook, Cambridge Analytica leaked its data. So now you're relying on the obvious situation. It is risky. So it might be feasible for the startups, for someone entering into this business, but the more your content grows, the more strong it becomes, the more security. Security
is part of the cost
of doing business, like insurance. So we need to give it the attention it needs. And the final one is, if you really don't know how to deal with security, better get an expert. They will help. Get senior developers, get people who have a great idea. Of our stay here, I think I'll beg to end here. I think for the questions we will take after.
Yes.
Thank you very much.